back again with more World Cup action. We have updated Kanto from Team US Metro here versus Snowy from Team Oceania. And yeah, he told me he's gonna bring, or he said in my Discord that he's gonna bring something that no one has used so far. So is he talking about Infernape or is he talking about Empoleon? I haven't really seen Infernape in tournament play, that is true. I've used it in a shot on live, but it was just a fun live. Like in series 2 play, I haven't really seen it. And Snowy brings a Gofagrigus team with a Mega Mawile. This looks kind of like the team that Gypsy King used in OUPL, but I think that team had a Kelly over the Greninja. And I don't remember what it had over the Tangrowth. I think they were 2 months different. So he's obviously going to be Stealthrox Landorus. And I assume he's going to be offensive Landorus with the Z-move. And I think he has to be Assault Vest Tangrowth on this team. The Kofag is probably Trick Room to support the Mega Mawile. And yeah, on Kanto's team, I assume it's going to be Scarf, Infernape, as it gets Stone Edge and it's a good decent Volcarona check. Mega Heracross. So they both have... they could be Rocks Empoleon. I was thinking they both have Rocks Lando at first. So the Lele, I don't think this is Scarf, I think this would be Shedshell or Twisted Spoon. So we will see the item, it's Z-move Tapu Lele. I don't know if I mentioned that, but like... like, I know that it definitely wasn't Scarf, like this time I finally was right. Like, I don't understand, people kept bringing teams in World Cup that were weak too. They were weak to Volcarona, and then they had Scarf Lele, so I'm... at least this, he doesn't have Scarf Lele, he has Scarf Nape. So his commit's gonna be Stone Edge, U-turn, Flabbits, Close Combat on the Nape. The Tangrowth kinda loses when we went to the Lele, and also... that Psyshock did so much. I think this is Modest Tapu Lele, they're playing kinda fast, so I don't think I'm gonna be I'll have time to Kulk. But yeah, the Mawile can definitely not lift the Z-move. I assume it's all out pummeling. If its team is weak to Celesteela, I could also see this being Z-Thunder, Gigavolt Havoc. But we will see, no matter what Z-move it is, it will definitely kill the Mawile. Yep. Okay, Z-Focus Blast, it's definitely more common. But I've seen Amy use Z-Thunder. And this is a Spadef Empoleon. I assume it's even Max Spadef because they didn't do that much. Like, this team is a little bit annoyed by Celesteela 2, so I could have seen the Thunder. The thing is, if Empoleon only has Scald to hit the Greninja, it's gonna lose to Greninja 1-on-1 and give it the Ash form. Oh, he has Rest. Is he Rest to his leftovers? I was about to say. Rest to chest in a way. So he can also go out to one of his Dark Pulse resists, but he can also like stay in one more time and go for... oh yeah, he really is Sleep Talk. Well, so I think that was the one that he's talking about, this specific set, Sleep Talk. Empoleon, I assume the last move is gonna be Defog. And he gives this Heracross a free switch in. I don't know. I think he had to double into Latios or something there. I think he had to double into Latios, or if he's Z-move Z-Fly, he could have doubled into this. But he switches it hard into the Heracross. He doubled into Greninja, so this makes me... this is kind of weird that he switched this into Heracross. I assume he has something to kill Heracross then. Like I said, Z-Fly is him. But he's Protect! When you copy a guy's avatar, you deserve to lose. Ultimate disrespect. So this is Protein Gren. I assume it's gonna be Expert Belt or Life Orb. That is a lot, so that's a lot for me. I was about to say that it's a lot for, like, for a resist. I know Grunja is frail, but still. So he showed protect on his Landorus, so I'm not sure anymore. So he shows spikes. He is, yeah, we already know he's Ash Greninja. In one video yesterday where I messed up, I thought that Ash Greninja was Protean. I already talked about this multiple times, so let's not talk about that again. He's gonna oh, I thought it would sleep talk. He doubles out into Greninja predicting. What did he predict there? I think he predicted the Lati slash the Koufax. And yeah, he doesn't get the flinch, so there's definitely max HP, which is about to be expected, and he's gonna go for a Z-move here, and this Landorus is probably gonna take like 90%. Yeah, 96, wow, so even a little bit more than I thought. So he switches out into Empoleon. Why? Oh, he's just stalling out the Trick Room. He's just stalling out the Trick Room, that makes sense. So I think he can go for... Oh, he's Pain Split, okay. Yeah, I think that's the same set that Gypsy can use, is it? Wasn't it? And the last move is either Will-O-Wisp or Nasty Plot. I assume the last move is Will-O-Wisp. But yeah, Trick Room is gonna end here, and he can... That he doesn't get the burn, that actually helps him because he gets another turn of leftovers. Because if you get the burn, the Koufax went down, yeah. So I can see this just clicking off quick here. You don't really want to risk anything, right? But he goes for rocks, wow. This boy didn't care, so I exchange rocks and... Kendo's Landorus is gonna go down to the HP Ice. So this really isn't Z-move. But he doesn't have a Scarf or if he's not Scarf Lati. And if he's Scarf Lati, that means he doesn't have a Z-move. Like not having a Z-move or not having a Scarf. I think he doesn't have a Z-move. Okay, he never mind. He already used Z-move Koufax Reverse. Okay, I'm actually insane. What am I talking about? So yeah, Ice Beam twice there. Snowy didn't have switch-ins at this point. Like I was so... Did I not mention that it could be Z-move Koufax Reverse early? I knew it would be Trick Room. Yeah, I don't know what am I smoking like. Yeah, Scarf Lati gets revealed, confirmed here, and Empoleon is gonna go for rest. So this is kind of cool to like check Ash Green, I guess, but you don't really do anything back. So. It's definitely an interesting set. I would have to test it myself to see how good it is. I guess it could also be a good good Tapu Lele check. Especially for Scarf Lele. Not for the all-out pummeling one, obviously. Going hard Lando is risky in case he scalds. You can definitely scald predicting the hard Lando. Oh, you said he should have fought at Nabe instead of Greninja? Not sure about that. But yeah, this doesn't even have much to touch the Lando, like, it's gonna be HP Ice, so I don't know... to touch the Heracross, so I don't know why he brought this in on Heracross earlier. Over the Koufax. I mean, Alphwick still does a respectable amount. So I guess the Lando's beat is 1-on-1. If he has D's on the Protect, this would have been a Lord play. I mean, he's faster, so he could have SD'd. Maybe he doesn't have SD, but it shouldn't matter. So that did around 30 something, so yeah, I guess the Herald still beats it, never mind. Man, I'm about to get mad, man, because I don't want to mess up my narration anymore, but it just happens when I stay up late. But the effect of the Lati Scarf Nape is gonna go for U-turn here, get a kill. This might live. But yeah. Now he just goes Tapu Lele, gets a kill. And Greninja can't go for Water Shrieking because of the psychic terrain. This barely lives. He probably ran a count before he made that play. And yeah, even if the Lele died to the Lati, he obviously can't go for Shrieking to revenge the Nape, and the Scarf Nape would have cleaned up anyway. Wait. Yeah, okay, Scarfnape obviously does not speed Lari, right? Scarfnape is 108. I don't want to say anything wrong. Scarfnape is slower than Lari. But yeah. He obviously had the save win with Lily living, and he hit from Lari there, bearing a crit. If he got crit there, did he lose the game? No, the Empoleon is still at full. So yeah, it actually didn't matter. Mm-hmm. Even if he gets crit there. I don't think a Lari locked into Psyshock and Electric Terrain would be able to like do much to Empoleon, so I'm just gonna run a cult to be sure. I assume it's gonna be max HP, no fist death on the Empoleon. Like just the set that I have here in the Cogspit death set. Just Garf. And Psyshock. I don't know where this has Psychic. And that's in Psychic Terrain. And Psyshock does. Why does it not change in Psychic Terrain? But yeah, it's probably gonna do um 30% to 35. I know the exact cult. But it's not gonna do enough to Empoleon. And Psychic Terrain would also run out, and then it would do even less. And the Lari would have been at, yeah, it would have been super low, so Empoleon can also Sleep Dog a Scald. And Scald should 2 or 3 kill Lari. So like I think he had to get multiple crits. I want crit to kill this and then more crits to kill the Empoleon. Yeah, thank you guys for watching. I really love quick games. I mean, I had to wait for this game because, you know, he's from Oceania. He just probably just woke up or something. And it's pretty late at night here. But yeah, gotta get that young content, you feel me? The next game is actually France versus, like, the next game that I'm interested in recording is gonna be a Mount from France. I think he's playing with some Greek guy, if I recall correctly. I think with Escavalier. That's gonna be in like 6 or 7 hours from now, and I'll see if I'll get some sleep in between those games, or if I just stay up like a wild boy. And I mean, this team was definitely cool, and like, it's cool to see him pick up the win with this team. Not sure if like Snowy uses anything specific that, like, if he had this Empoleon set for anything specific that Snowy likes to use, but yeah, definitely worked out versus Greninja, and it checks Lari too, obviously. And I still can't, like, I still can't realize or like get over that I thought he was Z-move Lando. Or that he didn't have a Z-move, that I said that after he showed Z-move, but yeah, it happens. And I don't know why I always have to talk about that. And yeah, I think Kanto is 2-1. I think, yeah, he played all his 3 games. He's on US Metro. US Metro has been doing pretty well so far, but there were a few games yesterday, or like a few hours ago, that they didn't do so well in. They should still be positive. Aim won both his games. I didn't record those because I didn't get the DPP knowledge. I will record them if I will get someone to call next time that has DPP knowledge. But yeah, overall he has like some mons that you don't see that much. I mean, Nagara Cross is not bad, but you don't see it that much in tournament play. And then Empoleon and Infernape, look at these three, nice trio. Whew. And yeah, so he went 2-1. I think Snowy, I haven't seen Snowy play. I think this was Snowy's first game in World Cup. I've seen him destroy Padlop. I've seen him beat Padlop in OU Circuit. I don't want to say destroy, it was 2-1. Padlop hacked a little bit one game. Oh, ABR said, I'm assuming there's like 21 World Cup games tomorrow. Holy fuck. Okay, I probably have to sleep then. How am I gonna be able to record those? I'll probably get people in call. Because I will be on like low sleep, like 4 hours sleep or something. Yeah, I think this was his first game, so he's 0-1. But yeah, he's been doing okay. He played all 3 games, I already said this. And we will be back with a lot more World Cup coverage. This is actually, yeah, you guys see, I upload a lot of these games. This is my main focus. I have one more shot in live pre-recorded. But that's like just a fun live on the low ladder with a fun Denny team. And that will probably go up on a day where not much World Cup happens. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. Dogwitch signing out. Goodbye.